Today we are going to do eggless harlequin bread. Harlequin bread is a mixture of your white bread as well as your brown bread, but we are not going to add any egg into it. It's just going to be a normal bread roll dough. So let's look at the ingredients.
Ingredients required to make the white bread dough are refined flour, yeast, salt, sugar, fat, and water as required. Ingredients to make the brown bread dough are refined flour, whole wheat flour, yeast, salt, fat, sugar, and water as required. To make the white bread dough, take refined flour, yeast, sugar, add water little by little, dissolve it, and start binding the dough together. We need to make a nice soft dough. Now, in 250 grams of flour, we usually end up adding 150 ml of water. This is just 125 grams of refined flour. So we'll add approximately 70 to 75 grams of water and see if we require more. The dough has to be nice and soft, but please do not make a slack dough. Knead the dough very well. Once all the dough has been kneaded, take it to the side. Take your fat, salt, and cream it together so that there are no lumps in the fat. Add your dough to the creamed fat and salt and knead it in. Knead it nicely till there is no shiny surface on top of your dough. Once that is done, if you find that the dough is a little sticky and difficult to round up, you can use a little bit of water or a little bit of oil and round up the dough. Cover it with a damp cloth. To make the brown bread, take whole wheat flour, refined flour, mix it together. Add yeast, grain sugar, add a little water and start making the dough. We can add the caramel at this point of time if we want a little bit of color difference, or we can add it later as well. Keep adding water little by little and keep on binding the dough together. Knead it very well. It also has to be a nice soft dough once that is done. Over here you can see I've added a little bit of more caramel in the end over here to give it a good brown color, because we're going to mix both the doughs together. So we need the color difference in the dough. It's not going to make any difference to the taste of the bread. Once it is done, take your fat, salt, cream it together and knead your dough into it. Again, over here, ensure that the shiny surface is not there. It's completely mixed into the dough. And round it up nicely. Put it on a clean surface and cover with a damp cloth. Once it's proved, take a little bit of flour on the table. Take your white bread dough and roll it into a rectangle. Ensure that the dough is not sticking to the table. Then take your brown bread dough and roll it to the same size. The rectangle is approximately 20 centimeters by 10 centimeters. That will be fine. Apply a little water on the white bread dough. Take the brown bread dough and place it over the white bread dough. Stick it together and then roll it up. Close the seam. Place it on a nicely greased tray and cut it or make gashes with the help of a blade. Prove it till it doubles in size, bake it, and after baking, apply melted fat over it. Cut and serve. Thank you.